What's up, everybody? Welcome to a new English Bit. I'm Katia, and I really hope that you're safe and healthy and making the most of your quarantine to enhance your English. I would be more than happy to help you with that. In today's lesson, we're going to learn 15 useful expressions. I recommend learning them by heart as they will help you sound like a native. Are you ready? So take a notebook and let's kick off. So let's get started. The first expression we're going to learn today is it is what it is. It is what it is. We use this expression when we have no other choice but to accept a bad situation because there is nothing we can do about it. And now some examples. The first one, we are in lockdown. It is what it is. We are in lockdown. It is what it is. The second one, the tickets are sold out. It is what it is. The tickets are sold out. It is what it is. And now let's move on to our second expression, which is it's a good thing. It's a good thing. We can also abbreviate and say good thing. We use this expression when we are glad that something happened or didn't happen. And now, two examples. The first one, it's a good thing that it stopped raining. It's a good thing that it stopped raining. The second example, good thing I didn't accept the job offer. Good thing I didn't accept the job offer because something better came up later. Let's continue our expression number three. It's on the tip of my tongue. It's on the tip of my tongue. We use this expression when we know something, but we can't remember it at the time we're speaking. And now some examples. The first one, I can't remember the title of the movie, but it's on the tip of my tongue. I can't remember the title of the movie, but it's on the tip of my tongue. And the second example, don't tell me, it's on the tip of my tongue. Don't tell me, it's on the tip of my tongue. Number four, it's right up my street or it's right up my alley. It's right up my street is British and it's right up my alley, American. We use this expression to describe a type of thing that you're interested in or something you enjoy doing. So it's something just right for you. And now, two examples. The first one, my current job is right up my street. My current job is right up my street. It means that I enjoy teaching English and making videos. And the second example, I think this series is right up your alley. I think this series is right up your alley. Let's continue our expression number five is long time no see. Long time no see. We use this expression when we meet somebody we haven't seen for a long time. So when the quarantine is over and you meet with your friends, you can say long time no see. For example, hello Martin, long time no see. Hello Martin, long time no see. Number six, just a little something. Just a little something. You can use this expression when you give somebody a small present. For example, thanks a lot for your present. Just a little something. Thanks a lot for your present. Just a little something. Let's continue our expression number seven, so far, so good. So far, so good. It means that things have been successful until now. We don't know what will happen in the future, but until now, everything has been okay. And now, some examples. The first one, how are your neighbors? So far, so good. How are your neighbors? So far, so good. Unfortunately, it's not my case because my neighbors are extremely noisy. There are four children downstairs. So you can imagine and you can even maybe hear them. And the second example, how is the quarantine going? So far, so good. How is the quarantine going? So far, so good. And before we continue, just a quick reminder to subscribe to my channel and click on the bell so that you don't miss upcoming videos. I'm very excited because we're about to hit 5K. And now let's continue with our lesson. Our expression number 8 is don't beat yourself up. Don't beat yourself up. It means don't blame or criticize yourself. It's a synonym of don't be too hard on yourself. We learned this expression in one of the previous English bits. And now some examples. The first one, I should have been more productive last week. Don't beat yourself up. I should have been more productive last week. Don't beat yourself up. And the second example, I should have trained harder. Don't beat yourself up. I should have trained harder. Don't beat yourself up. Let's continue our expression number 9. I couldn't care less. I couldn't care less. It means that you don't care at all. You're not interested in something or worried about something. And now, two examples. The first one, I couldn't care less what she thinks about me. I couldn't care less what she thinks about me. And the second example, I think he's angry with you. I couldn't care less. I think he's angry with you. I couldn't care less. Let's continue our expression number 10. Let me get it straight. Let me get it straight. We use this expression to make sure that we understood something correctly. It's a way to summarize what the other person said. And now some examples. The first one, let me get it straight. You quit your job. Let me get it straight. You quit your job. And the second example, let me get it straight. You watched the entire season without me. Let me get it straight. You watched the entire season without me. Number 11, it will come in handy or it may come in handy. It'll come in handy or it may come in handy. This expression means to be useful. And now a few examples. And the first one, I don't want to throw it away. It may come in handy. I don't want to throw it away. It may come in handy. And one more example, an extra energy gel came in handy when I was running the race. An extra energy gel came in handy when I was running the race. Let's continue our expression. Number 12 is each to his own, or we can also say each to their own. So each to his own or each to their own. We use this expression to say that we are all different. We like different things. We have different opinions, and it's okay because there are a lot of people and we are all different. And now, some examples. The first one, I don't like scary movies. Each to his own. I don't like scary movies. Each to his own. And another example, I wouldn't buy that dress, but each to their own. I wouldn't buy that dress. But each to their own. Let's continue. Our expression number 13 is the day is young or the night is young. The day is young or the night is young. We use this expression to say that there is plenty of time and it's not very late. And now some examples. The first example, don't worry, the day is young. I'm sure it'll get better. Don't worry, the day is young. I'm sure it'll get better. In this case, the connotation is positive. It means that good things can still happen today. The second example, wow, everyone is getting along so great today. No fighting. The day is young. There is still time for a fight or two. Wow, everyone is getting along so great today. No fighting. The day is young. There is still time for a fight or two. And the third example, I haven't seen any guys that I like tonight, but the night is young. I haven't seen any guys that I like tonight, but the night is young. Our second to last expression is stay on topic. Stay on topic. It means focus on what we are talking about and don't change the subject. An example sentence, please, it's very important. Stay on topic. Please, it's very important. Stay on topic. And last but not least, the expression, now I've seen everything. Or you can also say, now I've seen it all. Now I've seen everything. Or now I've seen it all. We use this expression when we want to say that we find something very shocking or surprising. And now two examples. The first one, I can't believe you're wearing socks and sandals. Now I've seen everything. I can't believe you're wearing socks and sandals. Now I've seen everything. And the last example, paella with chorizo by Jamie Oliver. Now I've seen everything. Paella with chorizo by Jamie Oliver. Now I've seen everything. So guys, that's it for today. I really hope you enjoyed this English bit and liked these 15 useful expressions. I'm sure you'll hear them a lot when watching series and films. And of course, don't forget to give this video a huge thumbs up, to subscribe to my channel and catch me on Instagram and do my daily quiz. So thanks a lot for learning English with me while being in quarantine. Thanks for everything and see you next week. Hang in there. Ciao!